Okay, what is up, everyone? So we are in the airport at the moment. I'm whispering because there's obviously a lot of people around. I don't want people thinking I'm a weirdo. We're in the airport at the moment. We are just in Burger King. Unfortunately, I'm not getting a Burger King myself. I have my oats here. So we're having our first meal. It is just about 6 a.m. Our flight's at 8. I am having 50 grams of oats, 30 grams of whey protein mixed in, and 100 grams of frozen raspberries. I decided I'm going to eat this before going through security, as I think it'll get confiscated because it's technically, you know, a liquid. So we're going to eat this now, go through security, get on the flight, have the second meal when we land, and then maybe the third meal when we get to the apartment. So yeah, time to tuck into this cold oats. I've never actually had this cold, so it's going to be a little taste test. That's actually a really nice cold. You want to show the people what you got?
So hungover.
Kelly decided that it'd be a good idea to go out to her staff night out and have a few drinks. It was not a good idea. She's already thrown up in the bathroom. So now I'm babysitting for the day. Prep hard at me, bro. Let's see what we got.
Just fries.
Just a little bag of fries.
It needs something to soak up.
Bit of soakage. Okay. We'll check back in a little bit later. Oh yes. Tell them what we're doing. What are we doing?
We're sitting down waiting for our plane to come.
Waiting to board. Okay, out of the airport, back in Manny now at the moment. We're just gonna head to the traffic center, do a little bit of shopping, and then we are gonna get the bus from here that goes straight to Wigan. It's about an hour bus, but it's only a couple of pounds, so it beats getting a fucking Uber that's an hour away. So yeah, let's go into the traffic center. We're gonna have meal two in there at some point. Hunger is actually quite good at the moment. I think it's just from being up early, so I'm gonna push the meals off a little bit. So yeah, gonna go in, do a bit of shopping, get a fucking Elux 3,500 Puff Legend Mr. Blue vape, which I'm craving. So we're gonna get all that sorted first. I'm gonna put the camera away. Everyone's looking at me like a fucking weirdo over here. And yeah, we'll catch you soon. Showing the people your Craigs. Try prepping with Kelly, not easy. So we're in the traffic center now for meal two. It's about 11 a.m. And what do we have on the menu? Not fucking Greg's anyway. We have some cold chicken rice. So there is 200 grams of chicken, 50 grams of rice, and then we have lettuce and red onion and a bit of spring onion, the sriracha barbecue, and lighter than light mayo on top. And we have our salt, little can of 3D, as caffeine needs to be high today to get me through. So I think this is gonna be the last meal kind of out and about. Next time we should be in the apartment in Wigan. I'll give you a little tour and we should actually be able to heat up a meal then. So gonna tuck into this. Can't imagine it's gonna be too enjoyable, but it needs to be done.
Mine is warm and flaky and delicious. So for breakfast, we're having two sausage rolls. As you can see, I've started tucking into one already. Very flaky, very warm, fresh out the oven.
Give us a little bite, go on. And welcome. We have arrived in Wigan and this is some serious setup. Come on in and let me show you. So we're back to the Trafford Centre. We've got an hour Uber. Check that for a nice little touch. Welcome to apartment 6, Connor and Kelly. So first off, this is just spare bedroom. There is a lot of rooms, big rooms in here. So spare bedroom, we're not really going to fuck with this, but really cool, really clean. Bathroom next. Very, very nice bathroom. Like the aesthetic, nice and big. Hopefully we'll get to take a nice show day poo here, as everyone knows that is essential. Into the master suite. And look at this. Look how big this is. Big bonus having one of these fans, as I sleep with a Dyson fan every night because I get super, super sweaty. Bed, class. Office area as well, so I can get check-ins done. Little wardrobe area, done a nice bit of shopping in Zara. And yeah, I'm not going to show you the view because it's Wigan, and the view in Wigan isn't amazing, but in here is. And into the kitchen. Look at this sitting room area. Electric fire, massive TV, little dining area, kitchen that she came fully stocked with. Bagel things are here, which is absolutely class. Just fucking everything you could ask for, really. So I'm gonna have my third meal now, which is the last one you've seen, the chicken and rice. And I'm not actually gonna heat it up in the microwave because it slapped pretty hard when it was cold and there's lettuce in here and I don't want the lettuce to be all warm. So I'm gonna have this and then we're gonna go to Tesco and get the rest of the meals that we need for today. I'm starving, I'm tired. We might take a nap before we go to Tesco. We might not. I think Kelly is hungry behind the camera.
Starving.
So we are probably gonna go to Tesco after this, then maybe take a nap and then pre-work a meal and go training. So I will catch you after this and when we've done the Tesco shop.
And look at our fabulous view. Nah, disgusting.
Okay, we are just back after doing a big shop in Tesco that cost about 70 odd pound just for a few days. That was for myself and Kelly. We did pick up a few drinks to be fair, but just got enough to cover us until we are leaving on Sunday. So I'll just kind of go through quickly what we got. So in the fridge, let me turn this around. Obviously, you know, four cans of the goat, the best monster, the pink one. Some eggs, they are free range of course, and then we have our egg whites. You'll tell what is Kelly's and what is mine. So she got some sour cream, garlic and herb dips, some butter, sriracha sauce, lard and light mayo. For me, we just stocked up on some water, chicken, cans of Coke Zero, and then just some dilute, that new peach monster, which I don't think is actually that nice, but we just got it anyway. I obviously packed my protein and my pre-workout. We are gonna go train in a little while. I'm just gonna get some check-ins done. Then down here, jasmine rice, the best. We have our raspberry jam, this drizzled peanut butter, which I'm actually excited to try. This is all for backstage. We have the best, the Waterford oats. So Flavin's porridge, bagels, got these red onion chive ones, excited to try those. And then we have our rice cakes. All they had was the sour cream and chive ones. Reckon they'll be nice. I like sour cream and chive, but it's gonna be weird putting peanut butter and jam on them, but we will make do. A little bit of dark chocolate, just a touch of sea salt, and I'm just gonna use this Chinese season to put on chicken. Then we just got like black pepper, salt, shit like that. Baked potatoes, and then just some nanners. And that is pretty much it. I think that is pretty much everything that is going to do us for the rest of the day, tomorrow, and then the start of show day. And yeah, that is pretty much it. That is the full shop. So it did cost a little bit, but like I said, we got a few drinks. Kelly got a few bits as well, and it is a needs must. So I am going to finish my client check-ins as I'm late, obviously getting back to people with the travel. So just get back to the remaining people, get my pre-workout in. Then we are going to go to JD Gyms, do a very light pull session as it's been a long day, haven't really slept, so just to get a little bit of blood moving, but not really fatigue or taxed body. Get pictures post-workout, send it over to Alan, then I have to send him over my weight pre-bed, and then just see what the call is then for tomorrow. So we'll check back in a minute. Okay, game time, baby. So check-ins are done. Onto pre-workout meal now, which is just 70 grams of oats, 30 grams of whey protein, 100 grams of banana, 25 grams of dark chocolate. And this is in the smallest bowl ever. So it looks like there's a fucking load in that. The jumbo oats as well, thickened up quite a bit. So yeah, that is what we're working with. Little tiny ass bowl. When we are doing our high day refeed, definitely just gonna have to eat out of the lunchbox because this is the biggest bowl that is there and it is fucking tiny. So going to get this in and then we are going to trek to the gym, do a very light pull session, get out and just rest because my steps are on like 15,000 from today, just from, you know, getting up, airport, going around Trafford Centre, getting to and from, going to Tesco, coming back. I need to relax, man. So all day tomorrow, feet up, doing absolutely nothing, make sure we're nice and fresh for the show. Going to get this in now and we will catch you back in the gym. Okay, so we're just inside JD Gyms Wigan now at the moment. It's quite busy, it's about 5:30. So a lot of people around, so don't want to be getting too many people in the background. But we're just doing a light pull session, just doing 2 reps in reserves. Not going to lie, I'm absolutely drained. We've been up since 3 a.m. Didn't really sleep before the flight. So the last place I want to be, but look, it's the last session before you get on stage. So I'm just going to have a play around with some of the different kit here. Going to follow the program loosely. But yeah, I just want to try some of the new machines. Just get a little bit of a pump. I'm not going to push myself too much here. Just keep it light as we want to keep the body fresh. So I'm going to start off with this chest supported seated row, as that's something we don't really have in extreme. It's the pin loaded one, really, really nice. So I'm going to use that just to get myself warm, open up the scapula, and then we'll move on to something else from there. So let's get into it. Okay, that machine felt really, really good. Really like anything that's chest supported. It's pin loaded, it's real, it's secure, can get a good squeeze, can really isolate back on it. So I'm actually going to stay on this for the second exercise and do it single arm and do a lat row. So the first one was more upper back, elbows out, driving the back, squeezing the scapula, mid back, upper back. So now we are going to go single arm, lean into it, drive the elbow down and aim to get the lat. So yeah, let's get it. Okay, right, so that is the session done there. Pretty quick one, in and out in an hour. I didn't record everything. There was one bicep thing I didn't record. It was like a bicep machine, but elbows were up here. But yeah, everything else was recorded. Didn't talk too much as it was fucking busy. Getting a lot of looks as, you know, a new person walking into the gym and being pretty fucking shredded, if I do say so myself. Very warm in there, as you can see, I'm dripping sweat. I had to just wait in the change room for ages to actually stop fucking sweating because I was mad. Dripping. Didn't really get any good posing videos afterwards, which I'm kind of annoyed about, as you know, it's the last session before getting on stage. The changing room lighting, it wasn't fucking great at all. I tried it from 2 different angles, and one you could kind of see the front okay, couldn't see the back, and then the other, the back looked good and the front didn't look good. So I'll put them up there, I'll overlay them or something, just so you can kind of see what it looks like. But I'm happy with the look, considering we have been on the go since 3 a.m. running on no sleep. I don't think I really slept before we actually got the flight either. Like, I didn't have a little kit before sleeping. So I'm fairly fucking tired. We've had 15k steps all day and energy is low. So I'm just looking forward to getting home. Feet can go up now, nothing else to do. I'm going to spend tomorrow actually editing these videos. Just waiting on Uber now, 5 minutes, which I don't mind as it's lovely and fresh outside now, so I'm cooling down before I get into the Uber and get all sweaty. So yeah, I'm going to catch you when we get back home and have post-workout, and we can just chill and not move for the day, because I'm after spending a fucking fortune on Ubers today. Okay, we are back home. Man, my legs are killing me. They are so heavy. Quads are cramping up. Really need to just fucking chill tomorrow. All I have to do tomorrow is go over and get spray tan and register, which is at the same time. Registration between 5 and 6, and spray tan is at 5:20, so at least I can tick them all off in the one go. Literally just chilling out now, feet are up. I'm waiting for my
post-workout to cook, which is just the 50 grams of oats, 30 grams of whey put through it, and then 100 grams of frozen raspberries, and that is it. So I'll show you when it's done. But you've seen it a million times before. We are literally just chilling out. I have that ambiance set in this apartment, which, man, I fucking love this apartment. It's one of my favorite places that I've stayed for, you know, something like this. Like, it's obviously not like a hotel break, but just such a nice setting, and everything is here that you need. So I'm just chilling, watching some Disney Emperor's New Groove, one of my favorite animated movies. Fire going and everything, man. Really just have the scene set to relax. So yeah, just gonna wait for that to cook, eat that. It's probably gonna be ready about 7:30. It's just gone past, I think 7:15 now. Then we have to wait for Kelly to come back. She is in her friends at the moment, that she used to work with. Her and her fiance had a baby, so she's there chilling with them. I would have liked to go and seen them and, you know, have a little chat, but had to get the session done, so not enough time to do everything, unfortunately. So I'm gonna wait for her to come back, then we're gonna get a shower, and I'm gonna get her to give me the full body razor shave. I'm after one blade myself, but just to get, you know, a close fucking shave. I need to do my face as well, as stubble comes in really fucking fast. If I one blade it, it's gone back to fucking scruffy stubble the next day. So close razor shave needs to be done, and yeah, that is it. That is pretty much this day wrapped up. Long ass day. I'm fucking wrecked now. I could go to bed right now, but I still have to get this meal and one more meal in, which is going to be the bagel and eggs, and then we can hit the hay, go to bed, and get a fucking banging sleep. Alan is going to be here tomorrow, and we're going to do in-person check-ins. He's happy with how we're looking now, even after the travel and all that. Sent him over some post-workout shots, the videos, and yes, just waiting for him to get back to me on that. And it's pretty much this day wrapped up. So busy day, exciting day, fun. I love to travel. It gets me really fucking excited for everything. But yeah, I'm winding down now. I'm very, very fucking tired. So I'm just going to get these meals and just shut this off. Okay guys, it is finally time to sign out from this long ass day. Last meal is going in now. We have one bagel thin, three eggs, 150 grams of egg whites, and I didn't fuck up the egg white omelette today. It is a masterpiece, folded in half. We have sriracha, lard light mayo in between there, salt, black pepper, you know the score. So we just finished doing a full body shave. Fuck me, that took a long time. It's 10 o'clock now when I'm having this last meal. So I'll be going to bed full, and I'm gonna get a good light in the morning. And yeah, it is well deserved. So tuck into this. I'm gonna wrap this video up here. Hope you enjoyed the video at 2 days out. When we wake up tomorrow, it is 1 day out, registration, tan day. And I'm gonna put that into a separate video and include it into the whole show day vlog. So this is this one done. Guys, I will catch you in the show day vlog, and hopefully we will have something to show for it. Thank you as always for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next one.